I think there's a lot of challenges in parenting today, which we all are familiar with, because it is a changing world. It's an environment that's changing by the minute. And as a working person, as an entrepreneur, I face the same challenges which all of us do in managing our work lives and our home lives. My first business was a human resource consulting firm called Synergy, which I started in 2001. I sold the business in 2008, and hopefully it's still thriving. Then I took a sabbatical and I started a rural resort called Balaji Farms. That's not a commercial venture, it's a more fun thing. It's something I always wanted to do in my life. Build a farm, you know, put out horses and donkey carts and fishes and rowing and stuff like that. So I took a break and I set that up. As a mom entrepreneur, I think there are just a few things that we need to take care of. One is obviously dividing your time. But two is, more important, using your time efficiently. The other important thing, I mean, I remember in the earlier years, and today it's even more possible, is to make good use of technology. I mean, today you can have webcams and monitor your children even when you're at your place of work. And you must do that. You should use that all the time. And you should use cot monitors and you should use other devices which help you keep a check on your children all the time. I think it's important that they should be able to stand on their feet, whatever their circumstances, and the circumstances are what we need to create. So we in the city don't tend to give them these options, and that's why I created Balaji Farms. My farm is a place where, of course, there's no television. What my daughter does there is rowing, fishing, planting, horse riding. She looks after the animals. We have ducks, dogs, doves, every creature that you can think of in an old McDonald kind of rhyme. And there are many such other interesting activities you can send your children to. There's a Japaloop Equestrian Center, which trains people in horse riding, and there are horse riding camps, and it really roughs the children out. So children should be sent to these places where they can learn to rough, and they can learn to, you know, there they'd make them do everything, right from picking up the shit in the paddock to washing the stable to washing the horse. They have to do it all. So, you know, we with our ideas that we must not do this, oh, it's better to just sit with a PSP and, you know, not get your hands dirty, are not helping our children. So I think for a working parent to bring up a child from remote, the few basic lessons are: help them stand on their own feet, let them do things themselves, and do that by repeated recognition and reward of what they've done well. And these are lessons which I don't think I really need to teach you. We all know them instinctively. It's just that it's very convenient to give in to a bribe, to give in to a more convenient way of, you know, doing things, that, okay, better to hire a tuition teacher. At least I won't be worried when I come home whether she's learned her math or not. But I don't think that works. It's very important that at least till they're 10, 12, you take up your lessons themselves. You have to find time for that. I don't know whether it's the mother or the father, both need to. So between the two of us, and my husband sails, you know, so he's sailing 3 months, he's here 3 months. So I'm a single parent most of the time. But it's very important to be connected with whatever your child is doing. So if she's studying, you have to know her lessons as well as she does them. If you don't, then you really are not a parent bringing her up. It's you're almost giving up her education. And if you're doing that, it actually becomes very more interesting, because when you're going to her school, you know what they've taught. You can engage the teachers and tell them, I don't accept what you've done, or you've done this well. So you are more participative in her education and in her growing up. So I don't think time is an excuse we can get away with. We make time for everything in our life, and I do for sure. In this past couple of years, besides starting a new business, I think I have a penchant for punishment. So I also started working with what is called India Against Corruption, the Anna Hazare movement for corruption. And I work very closely with Arvind Kejriwal now, and we are in the midst of forming Aam Aadmi Party. And I've got even more busier than I was. So earlier I could at least, you know, quietly take away my weekends and say I won't turn around. But when there is party work, one has to go, even if it is a Saturday or a Sunday. So it's not so convenient as it is when you're an entrepreneur to take a weekend off. It's more difficult now, but the child is now independent. So I'm quite proud that now she can look after herself. So she manages herself, she's figured out things, and you have to make her more and more independent. Like if she wants to walk to a nearby store, till a year ago I never let her go. So then a year back, I told her, okay, you're going to walk to the medical store and I'm going to walk 10 feet behind you, and you're going to walk as if I don't exist. So I just kept walking behind her. She went to the store. She bought what she wanted. I kept walking behind her as if we didn't know each other. And we didn't acknowledge each other until we entered the house and we burst out laughing. And then she was quite sure that, okay, she can do it again. So the next day she did it herself. She had nothing to buy, but she just wanted to go to the medical store herself and pretend that she had to buy something and come back. So now I'm okay. I know she can cross the road and she can go and she can get her stuff and come back. So it's important to spend some time training them and then leaving them to do their thing. And it's possible. And now when I'm busier, it's also important to have a support system. So when we formed a political party, the first thing I did was I wrote to my immediate family, whoever is available. Most of them have migrated. So we are a nation of brain drain. And the brains in my family certainly ran away. They left only this person behind. So, but I do have a few whom I can tap on sometimes. So I wrote to all of them, whoever are there in the system still existing, that guys, I'm going to be really busy now and I might need help with parenting and you need to be there for me. And well, they all said yes. I wasn't sure that they'd do that for me, but they did it. So it's important to create a support system. The help that I needed was, she horse rides, my daughter. And she was at a camp and usually she doesn't ever want me there. So, I mean, that's her place away and it's her own space. But this time she was going to do some really high level jumping. She was doing 5 feet jumps and all. And she was very keen that I come for her final day to see her jumping. And I just couldn't make it. Arvind Kejriwal was going to be in town that day and this and that. And she says, you and your Arvind Kejriwal, and he always comes at the wrong time and you're always busy at the wrong time. And I got all those bhashans from her. So then I called my nephew who works in Infosys in Pune and I begged him. I said, I will treat you to whatever. Can you surprise her, go there, be there with her? He said, sure, auntie, don't worry about it. I'll do it. So he's her cousin, her first cousin. And so she was there disappointed, thinking that she's going to be jumping all alone. And to her surprise, her cousin was there. And he actually, I don't know how these boys grow up and learn to be so charming. He went there with a box of chocolates. And he surprised her, he floored her, he filmed her entire jump, put it up on YouTube for the whole family to see. And she was mighty pleased with herself. So I think it's important for us to create a support system. So there will be times when you just can't be there. There has to be somebody who will fill in your shoes.